Welcome, welcome everyone. We have something here that you have been asking for us to review, and that's the JBL Boost TV. So you can see for the last few weeks we have been having a new TV in the background that I'm not usually using to watch TV, but to show you just some logos. But you can get things like this Boost TV to just put under your TV and have a lot better sound, and not only better sound for your TV. With the Boost TV for 200 bucks, you can actually also use your smartphone, tablet or anything else that you want to use to play music, and you can use this as a sound box for your mobile devices. But it doesn't have a battery inside, so it is not a portable speaker like the JBL Extreme or the JBL Flip 2 or 3 or the 1,000 other Bluetooth speakers that are out there. This is a local solution with Bluetooth extension, which is quite nice. But you can actually also link this to your other Bluetooth JBL devices easily, since it has this little icon which means that it connects with JBL Connect. It says it here in the background, all the features I was just telling you about, and it only costs 200 bucks. So I'm excited to see if this maybe sounds as good as a JBL Extreme just for your living room. So you can see it here again, JBL Connect means you can easily connect different devices and also listen to great TV sounds. Let me just put it down here and let's take out the content of the Boost TV. So first of all, you will get a remote, which is obviously nice to have if you don't want to use the TV remote to change the volume, but to change for different things without getting up. But you actually don't need it, because there's all kinds of buttons on the speaker itself. Also, then you have the cable, the light cable, you could say, IR cable for your TV. If you don't want to use this, but to plug in directly with 3.5mm chinch, that's also possible, since the cable is also here delivered. Next up, there is a few extra cables, which are probably, since it's a heavy box, for the power. Come on. So the PSU doesn't want to get out. Here we go. So standard cable for one end here in Europe. And then you have the PSU, which looks a little bit like a notebook PSU with 19 volts and 2 amps. That means around 40 watts or 38 watts. That's it. And then obviously we have the speaker itself, and all the way on the bottom, a little bit to read. So let's take it out. I'm only showing you this because there's all kinds of nice technical specs on these papers. The other one is just a warranty. So you guys can read, for example, here the frequency response, the decibel, the wattage, and everything else that you won't find maybe on some other sites like Amazon. But you can see here, if you just pause the video, all the specs here in the corner. Also, otherwise, it tells you how to use your device for the first time quite nicely if you don't have the manual in your box, since you bought it from somebody that lost it. Here, everything you need to know in English, and on the back it doesn't say anything else except for how to mute and that you can exit the learning mode somehow right here. So not that interesting. Let's take a look at the speaker, and at the end of this video or in the second part we will obviously continue with having it plugged into the TV and listening to it. This is just an unboxing and review video in one, like I usually do it with speakers, since unboxing is not that interesting for most people. So here's the back. This is actually here the front. It says JBL right here. We have the nice touch of a JBL Extreme here. So this is actually not soft touch, but a real not denim, but textile touch. Feels nice. The JBL logo is black, so it fits quite nicely to the TVs with the decent color. Then we have a few buttons that are real and touch clickable buttons, not just touch buttons to touch, so you can really click these. And then on the sides we have here the space where the bass will come out, I hope. Really good bass. And then on the back you have a few ports, obviously for SP diff for your 3.5mm, then your servers and micro USB, or just a power port, software micro USB port for updating your software here through this one. But it's not USB enabled. So you just have to take off now the foils here on the side, and then we could start listening to music or watch TV here with this little box, which you usually put right here under your TV, and then the cables come out to the back below the TV, and it will have a nice look and nice feeling hopefully to it. So let's continue with that in the second part. Thank you for tuning in, and let's continue. So we're continuing with the JBL being set up, the TV Boost, and you can see here I'm running a game. It's actually running from my smartphone over Myrocast, and what I will do is just start the game, and it tells me actually to upgrade right now, so I will do that quickly, and then we will continue here with the game and trying a little bit the sound system here. So I'm upgraded, and let's do that race, and the race will be around 1 minute, and after that we will switch to Bluetooth link. And you can see the JBL is set up by itself. There's no subwoofer right now running anywhere here, which is a little bit sad, since actually the bass is completely, not completely missing, but that's one of the things that I would love to have a little bit more on the JBL TV Boost. That's my experience from the last few days. So the race is starting. Let's try it here to escape the cops and to be just faster than our opponent. So you can hear the nice motor sound roaring. The game won't be that long anymore. Just have to a little bit to concentrate here because of the cops. They're trying to stop me, and they try to succeed, obviously. So 70% done here of the game. After that I will be just showing you guys a little bit of Bluetooth music. I know maybe movies would be nice, but in movies also there would be a lot of sound coming just from the front. And it's also not that interesting, since it's only a 2.1 system, you could say. And not that much of a high-end system. So these were the first 2 minutes just doing a little bit of gaming here. Let's continue with the Bluetooth. So just press the Bluetooth button here. I've connected actually my Samsung phone here, the Galaxy S6 Edge Plus, via Bluetooth to the device, and I don't have to do anything now. Just hit the play button and it should play at a really loud volume. Sun goes down, a little bit of bassy music, but let's just listen to a little bit of rap. You used to call me on my. You used to.
Yeah. You used to call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone.
Not that bad, but still, as I said, not that bassy. You will hear that especially with Downtown by Macklemore.
About to catch a back deep, past the heartbeat, Doogie, I'm the Ducati, Timberland, Khaled, Scott, Storch, Birdman, goddamn man, everybody got Bugattis, but I'ma keep a hella 1987, head into the dealership and drop a stack.
Again, after a lot of talking, let's do a little bit of How deep is your love? Before I do that, there's a button on here with a little person on it. Let's just press that. The sound should be a little bit different now. So a little bit more bass now, but still it's not as good as a JBL Extreme, but as I said before, it's not as expensive. For $200, this is a nice alternative to a standard Bluetooth speaker that you would have at home, like the JBL Flip 2, for example, or any other device that costs $100 to $200. That's a Bluetooth speaker, because this way you have a little bit of better sound for your TV also, especially if you have it connected via the optical cable, which I couldn't do right now since my TV, my 55 inch UHD TV, doesn't have an optical output for sound, which is amazing to me. I didn't even realize that till when I tried to test this guy, which I can just turn now off. It has a tiny little LED that's not even glowing that much, and we are done here with the full review of the JBL TV Boost. I like it for $200. It's alright. It's a lot cheaper than a Samsung, LG, Panasonic and other solutions that I usually have out there. Maybe it has a little bit less bass, but the features are nice, the optics are nice, so it looks quite good, and the plugs are also alright. So this is definitely something that you can think of when you want to get a TV extension sound box. So thank you very much for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe again to watch all my other videos also on my YouTube channel. Until next time, thank you much for tuning in, and bye.